So instruction set of 8086 microprocessor. So we have the instruction set basics. First, what is an instruction? An instruction is a binary pattern designed inside a microprocessor to perform a specific function. We have an example. We have the opcode. Opcode stands for operational code. It specifies the type of operations to be performed by CPU. It is the first field in the machine language instruction format. Example 08 is the opcode for instruction move Y to X. Operand. You can also say it is as data on which operation should act. Operands may be registers, values, or memory values. The CPU executes the instructions using information present in this field. It may be 8-bit data or 16-bit data. We have also the assembler. It converts the instructions into sequence of binary bits so that these bits can be read or read by the processor. Then mnemonics. These are the symbolic codes for either instructions or commands to perform a particular function. Example, we have the move for move or copy, add for addition, sub for subtract, and etc. Assignment of codes to registers. We have here, as you can see, if with no bit, the 00 is the value for AL. We have also value for CL until DI and DS. So I'll send this to you. Okay. Types of instruction sets of microprocessor. We have number one, data copy or transfer instructions. Number two, arithmetic and logic instructions. Number three, branch instructions. Number four, loops instruction or loop instruction. Number five, machine control instructions. Number six, flag manipulation instruction. And number eight, a seven shift and rotate instruction. And number eight, string instructions. Let's start with data copy or transfer instruction. Are you familiar with the move? Move, then destination, and then source. There will be a transfer of data from source to destination. Source can be register, memory location, or immediate data. Destination can be register or memory operand. Both source and destination cannot be memory location or segment registers at the same time. Example, move the value of 037AH to CX. Move the value of BL to AL. And move 0301H to BX. Okay, I'll give you an example. Before execution, we have this. The value of AX is 2000H. Now, we have to move the value of AX to BX or copy the value of AX to BX. What is now the value of BX?
2000H.
Very good. The value now is 2000H. The process is move. This is the source, the value of AX. This is the destination, the BX. So just copy the value of AX to BX. Understand? Another example, we have here, this is the AX, this is the BX, CX, and DX. Okay? All of them doesn't have value, but you have value of 40 here. Now, this is the problem. Move the value of M to CL. So, this is your M. Now, what is the answer? Anyone? Okay, the answer is 40. This serves as your M. The 40 here. So just copy the value of 40 to your CL register. Okay? Understand? Next, we have the stack pointer. It is a 16-bit register, contains the address of the data item currently on top of the stack. Stack operation includes pushing or providing data to the stack and popping, taking the data from the stack. Pushing operation decrements stack pointer and popping operation increments stack pointer. Example, there is a last in first out operation. Push source. Source can be register, segment, register, or memory. This instruction pushes the contents of specified source onto the stack. In this stack pointer is decremented by 2. the higher byte data is pushed first, the SP minus 1. Then the lower byte data is pushed next, SP minus 2. Example, push AX. Next is push DS. And push 500H. Okay, let's have an example. So this is your stack pointer. That will be the last part of the register. Then you can insert the stack pointer, the higher byte. Next. And the last is the lower byte. Okay? So example. So we have to push CX. Okay? So CX is this one. CH and CL is the value of CX. Now, the condition is you have to push the CX. So the answer will be higher first to the 2001H. Then the lower part, the CL, to the 200H. Okay? We will not use 2002H because that's the stack pointer. So you will start here, CH 10, then CL 50 on the 200H. Okay? Next. POP destination. Destination can be register, segment register, or memory. The instruction POPs, or we have to take the content of specified destination. And this stack pointer is incremented by 2. Add by 2. The lower byte data is POP first, SP plus 1. The higher byte data is POP next, the SP plus 2. Example, POP AX, POP DS, and POP 500H. This is the process. First, take the lower byte, take the value of this, then take the value of higher byte, then this will be your stack pointer. Okay? Example, we have the value here. The SP200H is this one, around here. This one, 200H. But you don't have value for BH and BL, which is the BX, right? Now, he wants us to POP BX. It means that copy the value of this and put it in the BX. Okay, so we have to start with the lower first. 200H, put it in here in the lower part. Then the 200150 on the higher part. This is the higher part, this is the lower part. Okay? So the value now is 5030. For your BX. Understand? Next. The XCHG destination and source or the exchange. This instruction exchanges contents of source with destination. It cannot exchange two memory locations directly. The contents of AL are exchanged with BL. The contents of AH are exchanged with BH. Example. Exchange AX to BX. Exchange AX to 500H. Let's have an example. Before execution, we have the value for AH or the AX. AH and AL are AX. So 20 and 40. Then the value for BX, which is the BH and the BL, 70 and 80. Now the condition, exchange AX to BX or BX to AX. So what will be the answer? Anyone? It's simple. Just exchange the numbers. Your AH now will be 7080, which is the BX before. Correct? Your BX before is 70 and 80. Now, the condition is exchange the BX to AX. So your AH now, or the AX, is AH 70, AL 80. Now your BH and BL or the BX is 2040 from here. Just exchange, okay? Just switch. Next, we have the IN AL or AX 8-bit or 16-bit address. It reads from the specified port address. So we focus on the port address. It copies data to accumulator from a port with 8-bit or 16-bit addresses. TX is the only register allowed to carry the port address. Example, in A-L-A-T-H. In A-X, comma D-X. So let's have an example. Before execution, we have the port 80. The value is 10. Okay? Understand? Now, we're looking for AL. The condition is in the value of ATH to AL. So what is the answer? What? What is the answer again? 80?
AL 10.
10? Okay, very good. The answer is your port ATH will be 10 and your AL is also 10. Okay? It means that it's like input the value of ATH or the port ATH to AL. So the answer is 10 and 10. Next, out 8-bit, 16-bit port address AL/AX. It writes to the specified port address. Port address again. It copies content of accumulator to the port with 8-bit or 16-bit address. DX is the only register allowed to carry port address. Example, again, out ATH AL, out DX AX. So let's have an example. Before execution, we have port 50H with a value of 10 and AL with a value of 40. Now, the condition, out 50H comma AL. What is the answer? What do you think the answer?
40, sir.
40? Very good. Why? You have to replace the value of 50, port 50, with the value of AL. Out 50, change the AL. So the answer, port 50 now is instead of 10, it's now 40, and the AL is still 40. Okay? Very good. Now we have the X slot. X slot, meaning translate, and the format is X slot. Operation, AL multiplied by BX plus DS multiplied by 0 to change AL. Flags, none. Also known as translate instructions. It is used to find out codes in case of code conversion. I.e., it translates code of the key press to the corresponding 7-segment code. After execution, this instruction contents of AL register always get replaced. Example, X slot. So we have here LEIA or the load effective address. The format is LEIA reg 16 comma EA. Operation, load effective address of EA to register 16. That's the process, huh? LDS, load register NDS. So LDS space reg 16 comma mem 32. The operation is you load the register memory 32 or mem 32 to register 16. Okay, this is always the source and this is the destination. So load the register mem 32 to register 16. When you're using DS, load memory 32 plus 2 to DS. Now LES or load register and ES, same as LDS. Load LS space reg 16 comma mem 32. Or load register memory 32 to register 16. Same with here. Mem 32 plus 2 to D, this should be DS, ES. Okay? Next, we have the LEIA or load. What's LEIA? Load effective address, 16-bit register source, and the address destination. LEIA also known as load effective address LEIA. It loads effective address formed by the destination into the source register. Example, LEIA BX, comma address. LEIA SI, address BX. Then number 9, we have the LDS 16-bit register source and the comma address destination and the LES 16-bit register source, comma address destination. LDS, also known as load data segment or the LDS. LDS, also known as load extra segment. It loads the content of data segment or extra segment and content of the destination to the content of source register. Example, load data segment 500H here to BX. Another one, load extra segment 5000H to BX. Okay, let's have an example. So first condition, load data segment 500H to BX. So this is your BX. Okay, this is our register. The value of 500H is 10. So load it first on the lower part. This is the lower part. Then the next one, 5001H, load it to the higher part of BX. But you have another condition. You have number second. Load extra segment 500H to BX. But you already use the 500H, correct? So we will be using 5002H now. Load 30, 5002H to the smaller byte. And then 40 here. Okay? Understand? Next. We have the LAHF. This instruction loads the AH register from the content of lower byte of the flag register. This command is used to observe the status of the all conditional flags of flag registers. Example, LAHF semicolon. Number 12, we have SAHF. This instruction sets or resets all conditional flags of flag registers with respect to the corresponding bit position. If bit position in AH is 1, then related flag is set. Otherwise, flag will be reset. Example, SAHF. So now, ayan, we have the PUSHF. This instruction decrements the stack pointer by 2. It copies contents of flag register to the memory location pointed by stack pointer. Example, PUSHF semicolon. Then number 14, PUFF. Instruction increments the stack pointer by 2. It copies contents of memory location pointed by stack pointer to the flag register. Example, PUFF semicolon. Next, let's go to arithmetic instruction. These instructions perform the following operations like addition, subtraction, increment, and decrement. So let's start with add. So the format is like this. Add, again, destination, and source. Okay? This instruction adds the content of source operand with the contents of destination operand. Add this one to this one. The source may be immediate data, memory location, or register. The destination may be memory location or register. The result is stored in destination operand. AX is the default destination register. Example, add AX to 2020H. Add AX to BX. Let's have an example. Before execution, we have this value. AH 10, AL 10, or your AX is 10, 10. So now, add 2020H, add AX to 2020H. So your value of AH, AX is 10 and 10. Okay? So 10 and 10 plus your 2020H or 2020, the answer is 30, 30. So now, after execution, the value of AX is 30, 30. It's very simple. Easy math. Okay? How about this? We have now the AX and we have the VX. The value for AX is AH and AL, huh? So the value for AX is 10, 10. And the value for BX or BH and BL is 20, 20. Now, we want to add AX to BX. So what is the answer? What is the answer?
30, 30.
And? Okay, that's correct. The answer for AX is 30, 30. And the answer for BX is still 20, 20. Because we'll just be using AX. Okay? Understand? Next, we have the ADC destination or source. What is ADC? These instructions add the contents of source operand with the contents of destination operand with carry flag. So it means ADC add with carry, the C. The source may be immediate data, memory location, or register. The destination may be memory location or register. The result is stored in destination operand. This one. And AX is the default destination register. So always on, we will always save on the register, AX. Example, ADC AX add with carry AX to 2020H. And add with carry AX and BX. Before execution, the value is AH10, AL10, or the AX10, 10. But we have the carry here, which is 1. You see? Now, what is the answer? If I want to add with carry AX to 2020H, what do you think is the answer? Anyone? Yeah, okay. What is the answer? Actually, the answer is very simple. First, add 2020 to AH. Then, add the carry. Okay, we have the AH, which is, we have the AX, which is 10 and 10. Add 2020, so it's 30-30. But we have another condition. We have here the what is this? The carry. Carry flag. So plus 1, the value now is 30-31. Okay? How about this?
and
20-21. No? Diba? We are just basing on the AX. So what's the answer again? Correct, the first, 30-31. And the second? Diba, you just have... What?
20-20.
Very good. Diba? You will not be using... You will not change the BX. Diba, we are only changing the destination, AX, which is the AX. Okay, we just use the BX to add to AX. Okay, so the answer is AX is 30-31 and BX still the same, 20-20. Next, we have the INC source or the increment. This instruction increases the contents of source operand by 1. The source may be memory location or register. The source cannot be immediate data. The result is stored in the same place. Example, increment AX. Number 2, increment 500H. So let's have an example. Before execution, we have the value of AX, which is 10-10. What do you think is the next answer? If I want to increment AX by 1.
11-10.
Mm-hmm. Are you sure? 1010 plus 1.
1011.
Very good. 1011. Okay? Now, 500H, 1010, increment 50. The value of 500H is 1010. So when you increment 500H, what is the answer?
5001.
6011.
It's 1011. No, it's 10, diba? Again, ah, the 500H, you have to have a value.
Oh, I thought the 5000, sorry.
Okay, that's fine. So we have here the 500H. The value of 500H is 1010. So be 1011. Okay? Next. We have the DEC source or decrement the source. This instruction decreases the contents of source operand by 1. The source may be memory location or register. The source cannot be immediate data. The result stored in the same place. Example, decrement AX, decrement 500H. So let's have an example. AH or an AL is 1010 or the AX is 1010. So decrement the value of AX. What is the answer?
1009.
Yes. But in memory allocation, it's called 100F. The value of 9 is 0F.
Oh.
Remember? So, if this value is 1010, now if you decrement, the next value is 100F. Okay? Then we have the sub destination and source or the subtract. Subtract the destination to source or subtract the source to destination. This instruction subtract the content of source operand from contents of destination. The source may be immediate data, memory location, or register. The destination may be memory location or register. The result is stored in the destination place, always here. Example, subtract 100H to AX or subtract AX to 100H. Subtract AX to BX. Example, before execution, we have the value of AX or AH and AL is 2000. Now, I want to subtract 100H to AX. So, what's the process? 2000 or 200 minus 200 minus 100 is equals to 100. So, the answer is our AX now is 1000. Now, how about this? The condition is subtract AX to BX. So what's the answer?
1000.
And always don't forget the BH.
1000.
Very good. The answer now is AX is 100 and the BX is 1000. That's how you subtract, huh? Next, we have the SBB destination to source. SBB means subtract with borrow naman, curry. Also known as a subtract with borrow. This instruction subtract the contents of source operand and borrow from the content of the destination operand. The destination source may be immediate data, memory location, or register. The destination may be memory location or register. Result is stored in the destination place. Example, subtract with borrow AX to 1000 or 100H. Subtract with borrow AX to BX. So before execution, we have the borrow here. Excuse me. And the value for AX is 2020. So how do we subtract? If you remember the addition with carry, so what would be the answer? This is the, and we have to subtract with borrow AX to 100H. So the answer is this one. 2020 minus 1000 is 1020 or 1020 minus 1 is 1019. So you can use 1019. Okay? So of course, the value before this one, if you have AX and BX, subtract with borrow AX to BX, the answer will be AX is 1019 and BX is 1010. Now this is for the last one. Then we'll continue on next meeting. Next, we have the CMP destination and source. Also known as compare. This instruction compares the contents of source operand with the content of destination operands. The source may be immediate data, memory location, or register. The destination may be memory, location, or register. The resulting curry and zero flag will be set or reset. Example, compare AX to 100H. is our example. And compare AX to BX. So this is the condition. Did you notice on the upper part? This one? Now we have the condition. If your destination is equals to source, the answer will be CY equals to 0 and Z is equals to 1. So let's compare. AX, BX, are they the same?
Yes.
Yes. So the answer will be? Zero. CY is 0, Z is 1. You just have to compare, huh? Compare the AX to BX. So we have here the formula or the condition. If your destination is equal to source, this will be your answer. So number one is the same. So our answer is CY is 0 and Z is equal to 1. Next, compare this one. What is the answer?
0.
This one, what's the answer?
CY equals to 0, Z equals to 0.
Very good. Because destination is greater than the source. Okay, this is your destination.
Source.
Okay. Then the source. Next. This is the source and this is the destination. How about this one?
CY equals to 1, Z equals to 0.
Very good. It's easy lang, di ba?